Someone.
You can't wait all night. We're choosing a bride at midnight.
You mean I'm choosing a bride at midnight?
Uh-huh. Be sure to give her a big kiss when the clock strikes 12 so I know who the lucky girl is. In the meantime, it's time you circulated. Oh, yep. Circulate. Good boy.
I feel like I'm the favorite dish at a buffet. An item on the clearance rack and on display. My options look as good to me as tooth decay. And she isn't here. Meanwhile, bimbos are beckoning.
Hi!
And she has yet to appear. As I evade this hit parade of imbeciles, one thing's clear, she's not here.
And even Mother Superior agrees. Technically, I am still a virgin.
So I wake up in the middle of a forest, in a glass coffin, with some random guy kissing me. And that's why I don't drink anymore.
And
And I kissed him and I kissed him and I kissed him. But in the end, it turned out it was literally just a frog.
My shaky grip on sanity is crumbling. And soon I will be married off and crowned the king. The ticking clock inside my head is deafening. And she isn't here. All this ceaseless unpleasantry. Small talk, banal talk, so drear. The princesses, the bourgeoisie, the peasantry. All small beer. And she's not here.
Come on, now's your chance. Sebastian, try not to say anything idiotic.
I'm not supposed to mention the baker or yeast.
Oh, for God's sakes, Marie, intervene.
Prince Sebastian, this night is absolutely magical. But do you know what would make it even more like a fairy tale?
What?
A happy ending.
Midnight, my time of reckoning. I'm filled with dread and with fear. And that is why I keep my eye upon the door. Still,